LDBC, this is your boy Coach Shelton Harrison. Let me tell you guys something. Let me tell you do something right now. Okay, I got a response to Mr. David Chambers. Because, you know, you seem to be an expert on weightlifting, okay? You know, I've been doing this for 20 years. And let me go ahead and just tell you my assessment is the same. Yeah, Keith Thurman does need to do weightlifting exercises. I don't understand. You can gain strength without getting mass. I mean, the only thing he would do was gain lean muscle mass. See, there's a difference between muscle mass and lean muscle mass. But I guess since you're the expert, let me just educate you, okay? You can do Olympic lifts. You can do clean and jerks. You can do snatches. You can do jerks, okay? You can do push presses, okay? You can do front squats. You can do all of these type of Olympic lifts without gaining muscle mass. But see, a lot of you dudes, y'all just think y'all just the experts on every single thing. And if I've been doing something for years and years and years, I done trained multiple fighters. I done trained multiple fighters in the weight room. I done gave them a weightlifting program. And you also do exercises such as yoga to increase the flexibility while you're weightlifting. See, a lot of you guys are narrow-minded. Y'all are pretty much real old school, and y'all don't understand the benefits of weightlifting for a boxer. I mean, just look at Anthony Joshua. You know, he weightlifts a lot, and his flexibility is not gone. He's actually very good. So, I mean, you guys got to try again, okay? You guys got to try again, and that's just the way that is. You got to try again. Because, see, this, what you're talking about, you know, and I understand that you have an opinion. It's a good opinion, but your opinion is suspect. Yeah, weightlifting is good for boxers. It's very good for them. And just because you lift weights, that doesn't mean you're going to lose flexibility and be too bulky to move around the ring. That's a fallacy. That is a myth. That is a complete myth. I can disprove it. I can show you athletes upon athletes who benefited, gained strength, and don't even gain weight. They gain lean muscle mass. And lean muscle mass and strength is just as good as building bulky muscle mass. There are certain things that you do to build bulk, and there are certain things that you do to build lean muscle mass. You do more repetitions to build lean muscle mass, and you can still build strength as you build lean muscle mass. That's just the way that is. However, see, we got all these resident experts running around here, you know, thinking you guys just know who and what. Keith Thurman would definitely benefit. He's not strong. He is not a physically strong person upper body-wise. His lower body is very strong. And his core, his very core is very, very weak. And that explains why, you know, whenever he gets punched in the solar plexus, he's always taking a back step. He's got a weak core. His core and abdominal strength is very weak, and his upper body strength is weak. His lower body strength, he's good. Now, with that being said, I'm talking about physical brute strength. I'm not talking about punching power, okay? Because, see, physical strength don't relate to punching power. And I'm going to give you an example. Tim Bradley, very strong guy, incredibly strong in the weight room, but he lacks punching power. See, let's not get the two confused. I can educate you all day. We can debate this all day long. Look, set up your video on the camera, and I'll debate you till the cows come home to roost, cock-a-doodle-doo, or whatever. You know, I get it done because what you're talking is, you know, it's not even smart. I don't even think you thought. I think you just made a comment based on the title of the video. That's what I think. That's just how that is. That's just how it is. You can talk all day about fights. You can disagree with me. Cool. But you know, you even disagree with me on weight training, weight lifting? Nah, not even. Because see, this is easy work. This is easy work. And definitely a weight room regimen would do Keith Thurman a lot of good. First of all, it would make him less susceptible to those body shots that he's always, you know, about to crumble over. And two, when guys like Showtime Sean Porter, they try to manhandle him in the center of the ring or manhandle him on the ropes, it'll be a totally different story. Kell Brook is a weightlifter. John Jones Bones lifts weights, lifts a lot of weights. And look how big John Jones Bones ain't that big, but he lifts weights. John Jones is deadlifting like 555 pounds, man, just off the floor. That dude's strong, bench pressing like 315 pounds, power cleaning 275 pounds for reps of five. See, these guys are very strong. Look at John Jones Bones. I mean, you know, his flexibility is maintained. Very flexible. So the weightlifting thing, it's a fallacy. It is a fallacy. Not only, I think Keith Thurman's power, he'd be knocking dudes out even more if he weightlift. But the key is lean muscle mass. The key is not getting bulked and getting ripped and getting as big as possible. See, that's what many people think. They think, when you think of weightlifting, that's what you guys think. You think of some big muscle-bound, muscle-head idiot that's running around you know, trying to, you know, smelling like being gay. That's what you think. That's not it. You can be just as strong as anybody else, and you don't even have to show it. You'll be lean and you'll be strong, and that's the goal. Keith Thurman needs to gain a lot of strength, physical upper body strength that he lacks. And that's why Sean Porter was able to bully him along the ropes. And that's just the way that is. It's your boy, Coach Shelton Harris. I'm done.